Like, when I say he's eating out here, he's eating out here.
Hi, I'm Marcelo McAndrew. I'm a cohort of 2020.
Alright, and Marcelo, so you're from the cohort of 2020?
Yes.
Meaning that you are a sophomore set to graduate in 2020?
Yes.
However, you've decided not to return to the University of Maryland currently because...
Yeah, so I decided not to come back to the University of Maryland after pretty much dropping out my first semester of sophomore year because I started a company with my friends and we've raised a substantial amount of money and I decided to pursue that full time.
So when did you guys start this company?
The company's called Gladius. We started last summer, so right before I went into my sophomore year, and then we've just continued it ever since.
What exactly does your company do, or what is special?
Yeah, so we're a cybersecurity company focusing on blockchain technology, DDoS protection, CDN. So we're heavily into the cybersecurity space. We're also heavily into crypto and blockchain technology.
Studying beforehand?
Yeah, so I was studying computer science.
And you studied computer science. Can you tell us a little bit how your previous studies have contributed to what you're doing now?
Yeah, so computer science really set up kind of just the foundation for everything I've learned thus far and everything I've done. I didn't really learn very many specific skills in school that helped me directly in the workforce, but just having those fundamentals let me expand on what I already knew to go through my own research and that I pretty much learned for myself.
And we actually spoke to a business major before we spoke to you, his name's Cameron. He's talking about being fearless. Mm-hmm. And I can clearly see here, you study your own business. Mm-hmm. While being in school, you decided to pursue that. Mm-hmm. Can you tell some scholars about, pursuing your passion and
being fearless is definitely really important. I dropped out, officially I dropped out in December, but I stopped going to classes probably 5, 6, 7 weeks before they ended. But to me, honestly, since it was I had such a passion for my job, such a passion for innovation, it wasn't a huge mental leap for me. I was ready to take it to the next level, and I felt like I was just ready to do it, and then once I did it, everyone was like, oh my god, that's so crazy, and I was like, not really, because I believed in it, and I knew it was going to work pretty much from the beginning.
Yep. Easy eating. So, best message for any scholars that might be struggling, they might feel like they like something that they're doing, but they might be going in a different direction, especially talk about that, give them a license to some of these scholars.
Yeah, I think that, in terms of having passion for what you do is just extremely important. It's the biggest motivator, the biggest thing that's helped me have success is that, whatever you do, you're probably, if you do it every day, you probably aren't always going to have fun, but if you have the passion and motivation behind, not the reasoning behind why you're doing it, it does help you get through, and I think that's what really, pushed me to success was having the drive to just keep on going, even though it wasn't always fun, even though it was hard a lot of the time. I had kind of like a plan in the back of my head, a goal that I wanted to meet, and when I finally met it, it felt really, really good. I just say, kind of do what you're passionate about, and just pursue it. Mix most up.